Hey there, welcome back to Michelle's Scrapbooking Thoughts. I'm Michelle, and this is the project we're going to be working on today. These have been around for a long, long time. This is not my creation because there's so many different versions out there. This is just my version. There's a bunch of them out there. It's created with nothing but cardstock and designer paper. I've added some pockets. I've cut out a pretty flower from the paper that I'm using. And like I said, these have been around for a very long time. You could go on to Pinterest. You can find them just about anywhere. Let me do some sharing here. Okay. So like I said, I'm going through my stash. I am trying to use what I have. This is some old paper from Creative Memories, I believe. It's called Reflections. And I've just cut it out. The paper already had a lot of silver foil in it, so the cardstock is a silver foil that I've used, and I love these colors together. I think it is so pretty. And then I've added some gemstones just to make it a little bit more sparkly. My lighting looks a little dark. I hope you guys can see. Let me turn on another light here. But these are pockets. There's one here, and this pocket goes all the way down. So you've got a very large pocket here in the front, and then this one is just, you know, about 2.5 inches you've got. But this one goes all the way down. And then it opens up, and we've got room for a good 2 4x6 photos here. We've got another side pocket here, a good side pocket. You can put tags, and it opens up. We've got another solid page. I think that's right. Then this has another pocket here for more tags. And we've got a longer pocket here, and then we've got another blank page here. Plenty of room for tons of photo tags here, plenty of room, and then the back. I did not decorate the back just because I felt like I didn't want to put designer paper on it because I felt like if it was over time, it would, you know, maybe something would get underneath it, it might tear, or it might, you know, get wet, and anyway, I just really didn't want to put paper on it for that reason. It doesn't really need a magnetic closure or a ribbon because you can see that it will close flat. And it's really simple to make. So, you are going to need 4 pieces that are 8x12, and you're going to score them at 6. I have done 3 of them, and I'm going to do one with you. Score at 6. And then we're just going to fold these in half. And you want to try to get them as straight as can be at the ends. Sometimes your scoreboard can get, you know, a little bit off, so I really just like to double check and make sure those score lines meet up. You don't want your album pages to be off. I didn't know if I was going to be able to film tonight because we are expecting some very bad weather. However, when I looked at the radar, it's further north of me, moving northeast. So I was really happy about that. Cindy, if you're watching, thank you for reaching out to me. I wasn't even looking at the weather. So, Cindy, I really appreciate it. Tomorrow, though, however, we are supposed to get bad weather, so I thought I better get on here and film. Okay, so the next thing we're going to do is we're going to start gluing some pages together. So, basically, We're going to glue one on top of the other. This is a really quick and easy album to put together. You could add more than, you know, 6 pages. I think it's a total of 6 pages when you're done. You could add more if you wanted to. Now, when you're gluing, just make sure that they're meeting up as straight as they can be, which is why I turn it up like this, to make sure it's even. You don't want your spine to be all wonky. And you want everything to match. I usually run my bone folder across just to make sure that glue really gets spread out. Okay. So basically, and then you want to make sure, because I've done this, you want to make sure when you're gluing, your pages are going like a book in the right direction. Believe it. It is January and it was 72 degrees today. 72 degrees. I was like, Mother Nature was trying to kill us a couple of weeks ago with the cold, bitter Arctic negative, and now we're at 72 today. Oh my gosh. I know you summer people were really happy here in Tennessee, but I was not. Last one. Like I said, you can make these in any size. This one, the final dimensions are 6x8. So it is a nice size album. Like I said, you can find all kinds of inspiration for these on Pinterest. These have been around a long time. I just hadn't made one. Okay, so when you're done, you have like a book. You're going to have your pages that you'll be decorating. So I'm working with white, and it's picking up every little thing. Okay, for your mats, they are pretty basic. They are pretty simple. You're going to need 7 to 8 pieces of what I like to call full front mats. Now, I only did 7 because I did not cover the back. If you want to cover the back, you'll need 8 of these. And I really love this paper because it's, you know, carrying on with the foil. So you just have to decide now what you want your front to be. I went kind of like this with the first one. But I think, since I've got pockets on the front, I really don't want to cover this up. So I really want to go with something more of a pattern. Let's see. Like a solid color, kind of like this. Let's do this. Because our pockets are going to go on the front. I don't want to cover up anything too super pretty. Although I do have some new merchandise coming in tomorrow. I'm super excited about that. I just got really crazy during the holidays and I just forgot all about, okay, well, what are you going to do, Michelle, after Christmas is over? You know, I usually order ahead of time and I did not. So I am really going back in my stash. Okay, so now we're going to create the pockets for the front. And this is what I'm calling stack pockets. And what I meant by this is, being the fact these are on top of each other, but this one, and I'm going to show you how you can create it to where this one will go all the way down. It won't be like this one on top of each other. It'll be all the way down. So these are what I'm calling my stack pockets because they're on top of each other. So you're going to need two of these that are 3.5 by 7. And we're going to do some scoring at 1/2 inch on all three sides. Not 4, but 3. We're going to make the pockets primarily how we assemble them, pretty much like I do every one of my pockets, where we're just cutting at a diagonally where the two lines intersect. Fold on these score lines, burnish them down really well. What I did on these is I used my envelope punch board to create this look. If you don't want to use that look, you can just use a 1-inch circle and go in halfway, or you can just make them straight across, however you want to do it. But I really like this look. So I'm just going to bring my envelope punch board in. And you want to make sure you fold the tabs in first before you punch, because this is your pocket. And I'm just eyeballing it. You could do all that measuring and stuff, but that is not me. But I just really like that look. So now we're going to mat them, and I did not cut these mats ahead of time because I wanted to see kind of how things were going to look and how I wanted to go about it. So let's go ahead and get these pockets on so I can show you how it works. Okay, so we'll start with this one. We're going to put glue on the three sides. Hold the sides just a little bit. And you guys know me, I do like to show a little bit of the designer paper between the cardstock. I don't like it just to be white on white. But you do you. You do what makes you happy. Crafty girls do what they want to do. Okay. Now, to keep this, to make sure it goes all the way down, we're going to leave this bottom flap unglued, and we're not going to fold it up. We're just going to do the sides. And then what we're going to do is tuck this bottom flap in here between basically this bottom flap right here is going inserted in these over here, these on this pocket. So, and then when you get down to the score line, that's when you're, whoops. There we go. So now you have stackable pockets. So now this pocket will go all the way down, but this one stops. So that's how you get a stack pocket, and you'll get that deeper pocket. And then you could decorate the front. I don't know where my paper is, but I'm going to go ahead and do these first. This is going to be a full front here. Let's see. Make sure I've got... I mean, you could do it anyway. Any way you wanted to, but this is a full front. I guess tonight I'll just do the full fronts, and then I'll show you guys how I made the pockets. Because you guys know how to decorate. And then I'll still give you the measurements for the mats of the pockets on my blog post. Okay, so this is a full front here. Full front over here. I think I'm going to go something a little darker. You guys see this okay? Let's see if I'm in the camera. I'll put it up like this so we can see. I knew when I was cleaning off my desk to film, I was like, oh, get all this paper put away so your desk is not messy. I'm not thinking that, hey, you're going to need those for mats. And if the video is not running too long, because I always feel like it's running too long and you guys don't want to sit here that whole length of time. Okay, let's see. For the angled pocket, this piece is 5 across by 6 long. So 5 by 6.5. And we're going to score it on 2 sides at 1/2 inch. Not 3, but 2. So basically 1 on the 5-inch side. And 1 on the 6.5-inch side. And we're going to treat this one the same way as we do the ones that are scored at 1/2 inch on 3 sides. We're still going to cut diagonally across. Now this is where you decide, do you want your pocket going this way or do you want your pocket going this way? And because I wrote on it, I'm going to keep it on this side. But before we do that, we need to angle it. So what I like to do, because this is 5, so 2.5 inches would be the middle. So I'm just going to come in to the 2.5-inch mark. And I'm just going to make a little tick mark. And this is 6 inches. So I'm going to come in at the 3-inch mark. And I'm going to put a little tick. And then essentially, you're just going to draw a line from each of those tick marks that you made. trying to do this without my glasses on. Oh my gosh. Okay, so we're going to put this in our trimmer and we're going to cut it off. Now, you could do this with scissors, but I don't trust myself to do that. So when you're cutting at an angle and you are using your trimmer, you're just going to put your point to point in your cutting track. And what I like to do, a lot of times if you're cutting this direction, it will butt up against the paper and not cut very well, or it'll leave like a little scrunchin mark where it squeezes the paper together. So what I like to do is put my cutting blade in the center and go up with it and then down with it. And then you don't have to worry about that. And then that piece just comes off. And then you have your angled pocket. So this would come over here. So I am going to put a little bit of glue. Actually, so the video is not so long, I'm going to use my tape runner again. And I'm going to leave a little bit of a border between the paper and the cardstock. So there I've got my angled pocket. And when you go to do your matting, just remember, I was going to tell you something about your matting. When you go to do your matting, remember to do your angles as well. Or sometimes if you even wanted to, you could use this as a tracer, which means before you put it down, just trace it and then cut it. That works too. Okay, so we got our angled pocket. Now we have a solid page. Let's do, oh, the back side of this is pretty. That's got foil on it too. Let's do that over here. Or should we do this one? I like to look at it. It's funny, I can look at it on camera. I think I'm going to use this side. And then for this side over here, we could do this, or we could do this, or let's do this. I like this. That one ran out. I love foil paper. See now why I'm a glue girl. I never get it right the first time. Oh, but it came off pretty good. Shock. Okay, so to create this pocket right here, we're going to need one that is 4 by 6 7/8, and we're going to score on 3 sides. These pockets are super simple to create. Like I said, you could, you know, if you did want to use the envelope punch board, you could use the 1-inch circle punch, or you could just leave it straight across. I'm just going to cut diagonally. I'm just going to continue on with the same using the envelope punch board. I'm going to add the middle. If you guys have a request for anything, if there's anything you're wanting to learn how to do, just shoot me an email. I've got my email address down there in the description bar, and just let me know and I'll make a video. Okay, so then our matting would go there. Now this is a solid page. Kind of thinking foil this way or this way. I think I like how I had it. I think it's going to go like this. Just remember, you want to stay a little bit away from your score line so your album will fold. Okay. My goodness, I'm running out of score tape. Out of tape runners. I'm going back to glue. I was hoping my order might be in a little early, but no such luck. This pocket is going to be, the large pocket is 4x9, and again, half an inch on three sides. After this, we just have one more pocket to do. Alright, I'm just going to diagonal. So this, you would just decide where, on what page you want to put it. You know, do you want to put it over here? Do you want to put it this way? Do you want to put it over here? I think this is super pretty, and I don't want to cover it up, so I am going to go this direction, being the fact that this doesn't have much foil on it, but this does, and this has a ton of foil that I don't want to cover up, so I think I'm going to put it over here where the foil is seen predominantly. Look at me get my trimmer out. Alright. This one is long. I might need to. This one is right at 8 inches, a little bit shorter. So let's go with 4. That looks good. And I am going to turn it sideways just so I can get that right. Leave a little bit of a border. So that looks really pretty, and then your designer paper goes here, and that page I really am liking because of all the foil. And I don't know where the rest of my paper went. I'm gonna have to dig that paper out, y'all. I'm gonna have to dig it back out because here's some bits and pieces. Let me cut a piece. It's 5 7/8 by 6 7/8. I've got a bunch. This is pretty much what I've got left. So these pieces right here are great for your pocket mats. So you'll have plenty of pieces left. I really like these because they seem to have the most foil in it. So, and I really like this. So, let's get... Now, when you have a piece like this, you want to make sure, if you want this to be seen, that you put this part toward the end part. So, you're getting as most of this as you can. If you put it like this, and I've got to go all the way down to 7 7/8, you know, this is all that you're going to be left with. And that's, you know, you want the most out of your design. So just play caution to that. So 7 7/8. By 5 7/8. Let's see, even on this one. So we get the most out of the design as possible. So that's going over there. This one doesn't matter because it's very busy. And it's not one directional. Okay. So these are going to go on here. Like so. So the last pocket is going to be 4 by 6 7/8, and you know the drill, 1/2 inch on 3 sides. Now, this pocket right here is easy. I know exactly where it's going to go because I don't want to cover this up. I don't, you know, I want the most of this pretty. So this is going to go right over here. Like I said, you could either, now being that this is white, I probably would mat that because it's white and we all know white picks up everything. So, you know, I may definitely cover that just because we don't want the white. It's already picked up some of my glue. So yeah, I'm probably going to, I'm either going to mat it with another cardstock that's darker or I'm going to cover it because. But that's it, y'all. I mean, it's really just that simple. And you've just got plenty of photo opportunities. Plenty of places for tags. Plenty of, you know, photo tags or just, you know, journaling tags. You have all kinds of spots that you can do that with. And I will put down all the mats for the pockets. So you'll have everything, even for the long pocket mat. I'll give you all those too. And the project details are always in the description bar. If you're new here, I welcome you. And if you could hit the subscribe button and click the bell for notifications, that way you'll never miss one of my upcoming videos. I look forward to next time. Thanks so much for watching and happy crafting.